Philadelphia, 1999, in a bar, a man named Santos nervously holds a briefcase in his arms as he waits for someone to bring it to him. After becoming too panicked, Santos leaves with the briefcase and finds himself followed by the waiter. He follows Santos into an alley and demands the briefcase. When Santos refuses to give it up, the waiter stabs him in both ends of his neck. Elsewhere in the city, a young lesbian named Jamie Dobbs is having sex with her girlfriend Carla, despite being in a relationship with an officer, Suki. Meanwhile, Jamie's best friend Marion Pallavi is being hit on by a guy at her job, but she is not interested and belittles him for the slang he uses. Marion later joins Jamie at a Y2K party, where Suki finds Jamie trying to perform on stage, and Suki gives her a black eye after learning Jamie was cheating. Back home, Jamie laments her love life while Marion is talking about going to visit her Aunt Ellis in Tallahassee. Jamie decides to join her and convinces Marion to go on a drive away with her, where they will pick up a car and deliver it for a client. The ladies go to the car service run by a guy named Curly and receive a car that has love as a sleigh ride to hell painted on the trunk. After they leave, Curly is later visited by two goons, Arliss and Flint, along with their boss, Chief. It turns out that the car that Jamie and Marion took was meant for them to transport to Florida since there is something in the car that nobody ought to know about. Arliss and Flint then beat Curly unconscious while Chief resolves to go after the girls. On the road, Jamie makes it her mission to get Marion laid, while the latter would prefer to sit and read her book, Henry James the Europeans. The two stop at a bar where Jamie spots an entire girls' soccer team, who all happen to be lesbians as well, and she convinces Marion to join them back at one of their houses to hook up. Marion awkwardly makes out with one of the girls while Jamie tries to get her out of her shell by helping her kiss better. After a while, Marion becomes overwhelmed and emotional and walks out. She is found by two officers who arrest her after she mouths off to one of them. Arliss and Flint chase after the girls, first by interrogating Suki in her home. She beats up Flint since he came in aggressively, while Arliss calmly asks her where Jamie and Marion could be heading. With their lead, they make their way toward Florida and come upon the girls' soccer team, who don't give up any info on the girls and mostly laugh at the two bumbling henchmen. Jamie bails Marion out of jail as they resume their trip a day later than they were supposed to deliver the car. They get a flat tire and have to stop. They open the trunk and find both Santos' head in a box with dry ice, as well as the mysterious briefcase that he was holding onto before he died. The ladies stop at a hotel while trying to hide the head. During dinner, Jamie offers to sleep with Marion so that she can have a proper sexual experience. Marion agrees and later enjoys oral sex from Jamie. Meanwhile, Chief and his goons arrive in town, and Suki investigates the case involving the girls since Jamie had personally contacted her. She goes by Curly's shop, as he is still lying on the floor. He tries to throw some papers up to get her attention, but she misses him, and his fate is left unknown. The next morning, Marion finds Jamie pleasuring herself. Marion then discovers what is inside the briefcase, a collection of dildos of varying sizes. Soon, the three criminals break into the hotel room, recover Santos' head, and abduct the girls. The crooks take the girls to the back of a dog track where they are tied up. Chief explains to them that the briefcase contains dildos molded from various influential political figures, and the one that Marion used belongs to Senator Gary Channel. Santos came close to exposing them, so he was killed for it. Meanwhile, Arliss and Flint get into an argument that leads to Flint snapping and fatally shooting both Arliss and Chief before he runs away. The girls free themselves and go back to the hotel to get Channel's dildo. Jamie and Marion arrange to meet with Channel at a bar in order to blackmail him in exchange for $1 million. After the deal, Suki finds the girls at the bar. Channel goes to his car and grabs a gun with the intention of shooting the women. Suki sees this and shoots Channel first, causing him to drop the box with Santos' head and expose it to everyone, causing a panic. Channel's dirty deeds become nationwide news. Jamie and Marion part with Suki and resume their trip after arriving to meet Aunt Ellis. Before leaving the hotel, Jamie shows Marion that she had two molds of Channel's penis for both of them. They then join Aunt Ellis on another road trip to Massachusetts since women can legally get married there. After they drive off, a bellhop misses them to let the ladies know they left their bag behind. He then looks inside and spots the dildos. Kindly subscribe and hit the notification bell for more recaps. Thanks for watching.